Here we go. Welcome, everyone. Come on in to the room and welcome, 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 everybody.
Come on in.
Come on in and welcome. Make yourselves at home. Get a good seat up here at the front. We are about to launch in 5 minutes' time. Come on in. Come closer. Come closer. Don't be shy. Richard, it's just me. I know it doesn't look like me. It's just me, okay? Welcome to the RPSM's virtual recital, a celebration of Black art and culture. Come on in, make yourselves at home. I'm joined by Charlotte and Portia here in the Zoom room, and we are your loyal hosts tonight.
We are enjoying these tunes.
These are composed by Dayton, one of our students. This
is a video
he created. And we'll get into it. But this video was compiled and edited by Dayton's mom. So a mother-son collaboration here that we're witnessing right here.
Beautiful.
Really nice. So welcome, we're just getting underway. Find a good seat, everybody. We're at the 3 minute mark. I hope you have your kazoos ready. I have mine here.
Do I have this right on the bottom?
I have a kazoo.
I haven't muted it and I haven't stopped the video. Is that right? Is that how you read that?
Yeah, and we're just getting settled. We're just figuring it out. Everyone's getting set, finding a nice seat close to the front. I would make sure that your microphone is on mute. Be comfortable. We're going to spend the next hour together. And we're delighted to have you here. It's so nice to see all the faces. Let's take a look at all the faces. We got Javante. Welcome, Javante. Great to see you. And thank you for your email earlier today.
Lives of change. I recommend you to come. We do have an amazing program lined up for you. So kicking off the show, we have Tespa and Austin on djembe with an introduction, a little background on the djembe from Tespa.
All right, so this is known as the talking drum, also called the djembe. It originates from all over Africa. They use it in ceremonies, baptisms, different types of ceremonies they have all over Africa. And this drum is the opening, closing, and the middle of it. So this is the essay of Africa, this drum. And I'll be playing a beat called Jansan. Let's hear it. Y'all give me your feedback. Tell me how you like it. And we out, y'all.
It is now my great pleasure to welcome our local MP in Regent Park, Marcy Ian, to say a few words. Take it away if Marcy is here.
I just had to unmute. Charlotte, I'm here.
Hi,
thank
Marcy.
You. Hi, so good to see you. I'm excited to be here. And Richard, so good to see you again. We chatted a couple of weeks ago and you told me that this was coming up and I said, please invite me. And I'm so excited to be here with you. You know, I have to say, Portia and Charlotte, when you talked about graduating in 2014 and coming back to the program, I thought, my gosh, what an example of lifting as you rise. And that's so important. It's so important that you kept that connection and saw it fit to come back and to mentor and to be there for kids coming up. So thank you for doing that. Richard, we talked about this, but thank you for being such an empathetic leader. We know that the arts matter, that people, you know, kids do a whole lot better cognitively and beyond when they're involved in the arts because they can be their unique selves. They can express themselves. And so we know how important it is. And thank you so much to RPSM for doing what you do because you are making a huge difference in the lives of thousands of kids. And I am just beyond grateful to being here, for being here. And I look forward to hearing some more. This is awesome so far. Thanks so much, you guys.
Cheers. Thank you so much for being here.
Cheers.
Yes, thank you so much. It really is a special, it's really special to be able to come back to RPSM. As Portia said, we never really left. And it's really nice to kind of see full circle the effects of what happens when you start at the school at like 7 and where we are now and this beautiful community that we have. So thank you so much for coming and supporting our programs and our community. And please stick around and stay in touch with us. We cannot thank you enough for making time for this event. Up next, we have Eamon playing Blinding Lights by someone who just had a huge event this weekend, The Weeknd. Welcome, Eamon.
And that was Eamon. Well done, Eamon. Thank you so much. I want you to give a really big RPSM welcome to our next student. This is Malik. He's wearing a bow tie, so get ready for it. Yes. Are you ready? Are you as cool as you were in sound check, Malik?
Yeah. I'm ready.
All right. Well, enjoy yourself. Remember to have fun. We're all here with you. We're rooting for you. And take it away, my friend. He's 12 years old. He's going to be performing All of Me by John Legend. Take it away, Malik. Bravo, Malik, bravo.
That was incredible, Malik. You weren't even reading any music. That was so incredible. People were commenting that they were singing along. Are you confident? How did you become so confident?
At first it was really hard, but then I got confident because I had my support from my family too. They helped me out through all the way. And my teacher was really encouraged me a lot to finish the piece and keep going until I got it.
Keep going, keep practicing, and you're looking so sharp in your bow tie. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. Well done. Next up, we have our senior choir, of which myself and Charlotte used to be members of ages ago. So here we go.
Bum, 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 bum
It's my great honor to introduce a member of the RPSM Board of Directors, co-founder of the 100 Strong Program. He was appointed to the Ontario Court of Justice in 2013. Ladies and gentlemen, please give a warm Zoom welcome to Justice Donald McLeod. Hi, Donald.
Well, hello there, everyone. Hi, Richard. How are
you? We're trying to get rid of that Zoom awkward silence. So welcome, Donald. Welcome to our space.
No, thanks for having me. First of all, the program is fantastic. I was able to hear Marcy and I heard the music and I heard, and Marcy's a very good friend of mine. And I love this organization. And I love the fact that, you know, young and old are all participating in this. It's fantastic. Richard, you're doing a fantastic job as well. And I bring greetings on behalf of the board. Obviously, there are other board members that are in the Zoom chat as well. But I said that I would speak for 2 minutes or 3 minutes on how important music has been to the idea of Black history. So when you're looking at music, you say to yourselves, how is music that intrinsic or that important towards Black history? In fact, the young man that was playing the piano, the people that were singing just now, the kids that were in the middle of saying Zoom like you're saying, how is that important? Well, I will tell you that one of the things that was most important in Black history was, in fact, one of the sort of the big marks of it was slavery. Now, why would this have been important? Because this was a way of communicating. Music was one of the ways that you could communicate with another person so that they would be able to know to get ready to gain their freedom. So when we'd be saying to ourselves, why would music be that important? You would have a person that would actually be singing while they're working. And we all know that music can set the ambiance in a room. It can set the environment. One of the beauties about music, whether it be a piano, a woodwind, whether it be you're playing in a symphony or you're just humming to yourself in the shower, your shower can be that much better just because you're singing in it. So one of the things that music does is it would change the environment to such a degree that the slaves would actually know that something's happening. So you might have someone come in and sing Swing Low, Sweet Chariot, Coming Forth to Carry Me Home. And in fact, what they say was that word was in fact, or that song was said to get ready. The train's coming, get on board. Music, in fact, has been the kind of thing that has liberated us as a community, it's liberated us as a people, to the point where you could even have situations where Martin Luther King used to say that just at the times when he was his lowest, he would have or call Mahalia Jackson, and he would have her literally sing on the phone for him, Amazing Grace. How sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. The reason why it became important for him is because that music, just being on the phone, set the ambiance, it set the environment, allowed him to be able to go out and actually say the things that he wanted to say to empower people. So when we're here and we're doing music, I want you to make sure that you understand that you are powerful just in the music that you're playing, that just in the notes that you play, the way that you play it, the young man with the bow tie, when you're playing each of those notes, know that you are in fact powerful. The group of kids that came and you were singing and you were making the swishing sounds and the big sounds and the small sounds, it doesn't matter how big your part is. It just matters that you are a part. And sometimes we realize now in music, in setting an environment, it doesn't matter who you are in that space, whether you're the best musician, the worst, or somewhere in the middle. The fact that you can make a sound, the fact that you can change a mood, makes you even more powerful than you think. So I'm saying to all of you that are here, all the people that are on the call, make sure that in this month, in this life, in these months to come, you understand just how powerful you are, that you understand that music is a vehicle for power, but it also means that with every note that you play, every song that you sing, everything that you utter makes you an even more powerful person than you thought. So thank you for inviting me. It was beautiful being here. I hope I see you all again next year or at a recital when we don't have to be social distancing. But I want you all to know, and I want you to know that there's gratitude here. I am thankful to be a part of this. As a person that lived at Belshaw Place myself, who grew up at Regent Park and then moved to Scarborough, as someone who has seen some of the things that this world has to offer, there's nothing like a good song, a good melody, and a smiling face. So thank you guys for having me. I appreciate it, and have a good evening. Thanks again.
We appreciate you, Justice Donald McLeod, and thank you so much for making time for our community and sharing your perspective tonight. And as you've done now over several years and all that you put into to RPSM and to the community at large, thank you.
No, thank you all. Thank you, I appreciate it. Thanks a lot, Richard, and thanks for your hard work.
Right on.
So next up, we have Elias to perform Don't Worry, Be Happy. How fitting. The song is by one-of-a-kind artist, Bobby McFerrin. Did you know this was the first a cappella song to reach number one on the Billboard? Though McFerrin is widely known for the song, he is a multi-Grammy award-winning jazz vocalist, collaborating with other greats such as Herbie Hancock, Chick Corea, and Yo-Yo Ma. Here's Elias with his rendition of Don't Worry, Be Happy, on guitar. Take it away, Elias.
Okay, thank you very much. Thank you. I was gonna do an R&B hip hop thing, but I chose Don't Worry, Be Happy. I'm
Next up, we have a regular performer. She would have performed in all of our virtual open mics and recitals since the pandemic. She only missed one because her voice was a little tired that night. Otherwise, she said she would be here 5 out of 5. She's been to 4 of these to perform, so she should be a familiar face to many of you. Here she is now. I'm delighted to welcome her back to the RPSM virtual environment to perform. This is the finale by Gallant from the show Steven Universe, which she's very passionate about. We were asking her questions about it in the pre-show, in the sound check. And Ali, take it away. The stage is yours. We're excited to have you.
Hi, everyone. I'm back. And I am here with one of my favorite songs. So I guess I'm going to sing it out. Here I am in the future. Here I am in the future once again. You cherish this moment I'm spending with friends. I know we'll change. It may be strange, but here we are in the future, never ends. If I could have just stopped, I may never have gotten to see this future for us, this future for them, this future for me. And even as we take the final bow, because of this, I'll always think of how there may be other battles to be won. But unlike my life story isn't done. So happily we'll face whatever comes our way, and after we might do it all again, and maybe things will change. Yeah, might be strange, but here we are in the future with our friends, and so happily ever after never
ends. Yes! Woo! Standing ovation and the crowd goes wild. That was so incredible. But now we have another performance. Someone joining us all the way from Iceland. We have Matea. But before going to Iceland, she studied with us in our DJ and voice programs and continues to study with us virtually with Trey Robinson. So shout out, and also a shout out to Matea's mom, Sheena, who was a regular volunteer in our percussion and community band programs. We miss all our volunteers and can't wait to make music with you all again soon. So take it away, Matea.
Broken down and tired of living life on a merry-go-round, and you can't find the fighter, but I see it in you, so we can walk it out. Move mountains, we can walk it out. Move mountains. And I'll rise like the day. I'll rise up, I'll rise unafraid. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. And I'll rise up, high like the waves. I'll rise up, in spite of the ache. I'll rise up, and I'll do it a thousand times again. Of the egg, I will rise a thousand times again, and we'll rise up high like the waves. We'll rise up in spite of the ache. We'll rise up, and we'll do it a thousand times again.
I'd like to highlight a program that was supported by producer Frank Dukes and the Kingsway Music Library. We're so thankful for these kinds of special projects that allow us to go much deeper with our students. The course was entitled Who Am I? And was facilitated by local artists and school Debbie Young, all the way from London, England, where Debbie is completing a PhD. Here's Debbie to say a few words about the program.
Hi everyone, my name is Debbie Young Annie Tafrica, and I had the incredible pleasure of working with Jasper on the Who Am I program at Regent Park School of Music last fall. It was incredible. That program ended up leading and mentoring me. Yes, it did. Working with Jadzia and Marfat and Salam and Dayton was a truly transformative experience, not only for them, but for us who were leading the program. Programs like these at places like Regent Park School of Music are crucial for the continued development of young people. I particularly come out of mentorship programs. I was a youth in the Fresh Arts program, and so many of my contemporaries who are now leaders in Canada's social and performance art spaces also come from mentorship programs. It's incredible to see Regent Park School of Music continuing this crucial tradition. It's really fundamental that these programs are funded so that young people can be provided with the space to continue to grow and develop, to question, and of course, to have a lot of fun.
Thank you so much, Debbie, for all that you continue to put into our programs. What a collaboration it's been, as Charlotte was mentioning, and we're delighted to be able part of that with you. We'd now like to highlight a few of the students who took part in this emerging artist residency as part of our finale tonight. You've already heard Dayton's composed music at the start of our recital this evening. And also in the background, as we were talking, those were all Dayton's beats. And we're really proud of the work that he's been doing as one of our young DJs. Next, I'd like to call on Salam to the stage to perform Lift Every Voice. She will be followed by Jadzia on the cello and Debbie actually closing our show out with a poem tonight. So, and let's everybody stand for this as Salem is going to perform this hymn by James Weldon Johnson, Lift Every Voice. So Salem, take it away. The stage is yours. Thank you for being here.
Thank you. Lift every voice and sing till earth and heaven ring. Ring with the harmonies of liberty. Let our
hello. Happy Black History Month. My name is Jadzia Elfrington. I play the cello. I've been a cello student at the Regent's Park School of Music for over 5 years. Though recently, I guess last year, I did another program called Who Am I? It was run by a very nice woman named Debbie and Jasper. And there we just explored things that we value personally, things that we value about ourselves. And it was a really fun experience. We learned about ourselves as artists and ourselves as just human beings. And at the end of the program, we threw a recital. And so this is one of the pieces that I played. It's a cello piece called The Swan by Camille Saint-Saëns.
Thank you.
So I picked this piece because the swan is a part of, I guess, a bigger piece of music called The Carnival Animals. And as many of you probably know, around February is when we have carnival, which is a celebration, not just a party, but also celebrating the fact that we are not just individuals, we are part of a bigger community, whether that's the Black community or any community that you're in. It's kind of a celebration to let you know you're not alone.
Hello to the entire family community at Regent Park School of Music. My name is Debi Young Annie Tafrica, and it is truly an honor to join you via the interweb as we celebrate our past, our present, and our future. Young Black girl said, I have to tell you something. Don't believe them when they try to put you in a box and leave you there to rot. You can give the world a talk. Walk your walk. Young Black boy said, I have to tell you something. You are brilliant and beautiful and strong and rare. Do all the great things you dare. You can teach the world your truth, know your roots, because I am more than my hips, my lips, the thickness, the depths, the glimity, glamity, hole whomever tight, all true, whichever night is not my priority. I play ball like a baller. My body pre-sculpted these centuries of mule hauling, cotton sugar cane picking. Sometimes even my own grave digging doesn't mean my only dream is to become a basketball star or track and field hero or soul singing person. Yeah, I can be an athlete or storyteller if I choose, but I know that these are not my only options. Why? Because I am young and brilliant, my ancestors stubborn and resilient. Built on their backs, bloodlines of future insistent on survival. We redefining some box and encouraging people to get corrective lenses so they can truly see we. We sometimes walking through detectors in schools that refuse to detect the rape and pillage we recolonized by some great aristocracy. We experiencing the military's militarization of high school, middle school education, officers turn hall monitors like this war on terror. It feels like a war on people, our warmongers terrorizing Black, Indigenous, Brown, youth of color. For what? The future? Are we preserving some facade when our populations are growing exponentially, spilling over some multi-culti melting pot and somebody keeps telling us to keep the Indigenous peoples off their land and keep these immigrants beyond our human-made borders? And if that doesn't work, then we suspend young people from schools. And if that doesn't work, then we expel young peoples from schools. And if that doesn't work, then sometimes we close down the schools, sending us to learn trades instead. Nothing wrong with trades. We need trade workers. But that is also not our only option. Streamline math and English F class, no university for we, because we knew that we are the new underclass, a new generation of worker ants, while we ignore them sending mostly poor, young, brown, Black, yellow, red, and white children. Are we sending children to fight wars? Are we sending children to die at war? Why? Young Black girl said, I have to tell you something. To survive these times, you've got to be strong of mind. Don't be afraid to shine. Hold your head up high and stride. Walk with pride. Young Black boy said, I have to tell you something. I know it takes a lot to become a man. Sometimes it's hard to find a good foundation. So you got to be your own example, son. Refuse other people's guns. After school projects cut while they make projects out of our neighborhoods and recreate the new apartments gentrified, moving us to our neighborhoods. Extracurricular activities replaced by what? Malls and prisons and Prozac and suicide. Suppliers supplying young Black brilliant dealers and buyers of an old boys club economy telling us that whether it's crack cocaine or cotton, we are steady picking, picking, picking. Black mother steady reaping. Weeping. Because my brother's dead or in a jail or in a madhouse. And my sister, she just been beat up or gang raped or diagnosed as manic depressive or jumped the tracks or the 401. We want more than malls and prisons and Prozac and suicide and 10:30 curfews and Coca-Cola Happy Meals or the latest escapist joyride. Because sometimes we are not happy. We are young, black, brilliant, wanting more than a piece of dry up apple pie. Wanting more. Wanting more, wanting life, wanting joy. Young black girl said, I have to tell you something. You have a right to liberation. You have a right to self-protection. You have a right to happiness and love in Adelan. Young black boy said, I have to tell you something. You have to fight them segregation, fight them criminalization, demand respect and admiration and love in Adelan, because you are young and black and brilliant. And you are our ancestors' wildest, most miraculous dream. Because you are you in your uniqueness, and we love you. We love you. I have to tell you something, young black girl. I gotta tell you something, young black boy. I gotta tell you something, young black human. You are why I sing. You are truly why I sing.
Oh, thank you so much, Debbie Young. That was Debbie Young all the way from London, England, sharing with our community, with our a part of our RPSM family. And we are so thankful to Frank Dukes, everyone at Kingsway for supporting that program. Which was part of the Who Am I program that we look to develop into this year, into this coming semester. So we thank you so much, Debbie, for your leadership. And everyone, thank you, all of our students. Tonight, you lifted us up tonight, and we can't thank you enough. Keep practicing your instruments, okay? You're an inspiration to us all. And let's all unmute our microphones.
Hi.
And sing the night away. Good night, everyone, and we'll see you soon.
Bye. Good night. Bye, Richard. Bye, Richard.
Bye, Richard.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.